गुड आफ्टरनून टू द जजेस द चेयर पर्सन्स एंड ऑल माय नेम इज पूनम मून आई एम करेंटली वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट जीएच रायसन यूनिवर्सिटी अमरावती एंड टुडे आई एम प्रेजेंटिंग अ पेपर ऑन अ टॉपिक ऑफ कॉमन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ डिसगाइज्ड सिग्नेचर अ प्रिलिमिनरी स्टडी सो द एब्स्ट्रैक्ट ऑफ द स्टडी The disguised signature is a type of signature in which the person willfully attempts to mask his identity by making some modifications in his signature because he wants to hide his identity from getting caught. It is generally found in the cases such as forgery, kidnapping, blackmailing, etc. The study was carried out on 75 healthy adult individuals from Nagpur region. Characteristics of disguise signature were studied using handheld illuminated microscope. Differences in the controlled and disguised signatures were observed in seven characteristics, which are letter size, slant, angularity, word spacing, initial capital letter, and fluency of writing. And it was concluded from the study that the disguise signature, that a person who tried to disguise their signature were not consistent and were not successful in fully disguising their signature. Can you please change the slide? Thanks. Disguise signature is any deliberate attempt to alter one's signature to prevent recognition. It is a type of signature generally found in anonymous letters, blackmail, attempts, ransom notes, threats, and similar documents. Request signatures are also subject to disguise when a writer does not want to be identified. Fraudulent checks and credit card transactions sometimes contains disguised signatures when a writer uses a fictitious name or creates simple forgery. Disguised signature present problems to the document examiners because they may fail to identify the writer because of the pictorial differences, or the examiner may attribute the signature to the wrong person as well. Conversely, disguise may be erroneously suspected. Examiners run the risk of dismissing dissimilarities as disguise when they indicate a different writer. So it is very important for the document examiners to distinguish between normal signature and the disguised signature. Next. So here is the methodology. We have collected samples from 75 individuals. From each individual, we have collected 10 signature samples, out of which 5 original signatures and 5 were disguised. So in all total, we have collected 375 original and 375 were disguised. And our criteria for inclusion and exclusion were, we have excluded the samples belonging to the age group below than 18 years and above 58 years. Okay. Then we have examined the signature samples with the help of handheld illuminated microscope, and we have studied the common characteristics there in both the samples, the quotient and the controlled and the disguised samples. So here you can see some of the differences that we have seen in our samples. First, most of the people used to change the letter size in their signatures. Some were using spacing, some used to give more spaces in their signatures, and some people used to change the slant of their signatures. But in some of the samples, there were some similarities also, just like the presence of dots and the line that we give after the signature, and the letter formation and the formation of loops. So there were some similarities also and some differences also. So it was not 100% disguised. The result was, the out of 75 individuals, only 43 individuals were able to effectively disguise their signature samples, and the rest 32 individuals were not successful in disguising their signatures. It was found that most of the individuals were not consistent and successful in disguising their handwriting. It was observed that a person tends to make modifications in the class characters of handwriting. And most characters include changing the slant, letter size, movement, speed of writing, and alignment. And the conclusion, by careful observation, it is possible to distinguish between the original signatures. It is observed that while disguising signatures, individuals tend to change the class characters of the handwriting, but the individual characters were not changed. Successful identification depends on the number of standard samples which are available for the comparison, nature of the sample, and also on the skills of the examiner. So here I end my presentation. Thank you so much.